Hey everybody, it's me! It's your old pal Dan Classic, and I'm back again with another channel update for the fall. It is finally fall! It's the first week of October, and just like I did last year, I'm gonna do a channel update this week here, and then give you a little something special here at the end. It's gonna be the, just like I did last year, gonna be doing some Halloween episodes, horror themed shit. So look forward to that. But before we get down to that, I have to give you the channel update. Just over a year, I've got over 100 videos on the channel, or at least I will by the end of this year. I'll have over 100 videos on the channel. In the original iteration of the channel, maybe had 20 videos, something like that. When I went to change everything over, bring it all back after I deleted everything. Not everything made it back onto the channel. Some of it's there, some of it's not. You can go back and take a look at it if you want to. Now we're gonna get to the point where we have over 100 videos on the channel, nearly 350 subscribers as of this recording, and nearly 25,000 views. So, and while that might not be a big deal for some people and some channels, to me, that's a huge, huge milestone, big fucking deal for the channel, and I just wanted to say thank you. Thank you so much for helping make this possible. It's been a lot of fun making all these videos, and even though maybe things have slowed down a little bit, if you hadn't noticed, I have been skipping weeks here in September, and that might continue here into the future. I might not have as much time to put into the videos as I used to, but I'm gonna continue making them because the support and the engagement helps keep me motivated. So I wanted to thank everybody kind of involved. If I missed somebody, I apologize. Hey, let me know in the comments below, leave a comment. First of all, gotta thank Raz Holly, as I always do. He's the guy that helped me get started in making videos. Taught me how to use the editing software, was actually producing my videos when I was first making them, and without him, I wouldn't have this channel. So if you don't like this channel, and you don't like how good I'm doing and how happy I'm feeling about it, you can blame Raz Holly, because it's his fault that the channel exists. Thank you, Raz. And then next up is Brandon Kirkpatrick, a guy that I've known online. Never met him in real life, but I've known him online for years, like way, way back in the DeviantArt days. Way back before I owned a smartphone. I knew Brandon Kirkpatrick via DeviantArt, was a guy who was making web comics. So I always kind of went to him for help and advice, and he's always been super generous with it. Super cool guy, also has a YouTube channel. Links down below. You know the fucking drill. Next up, I want to thank one of my oldest friends, Jamelyn, who may not appear on the channel at all at any time. He might appear in the future at some point, but hasn't yet to appear in physical form just yet on the channel. May appear here in the future, but it is always has some sort of influence. I'm constantly talking to him about the content on the channel, and he helps me with ideas and stuff for reviews and things like that. So without him, this wouldn't be happening either. So hey, thanks, bud. And then also Barry Punzalan. Punzalan, is that how you say your last name, Barry? I don't know. I just know he spells his first name wrong. And but he's a cool guy, and he helped me out getting started in all this, really, because he was the guy that was running the website, the superhammerbros.com, of which I was a part, Raz Holly was a part, and Jamelyn was a part. There was an old podcast, the Super Hammer Bros podcast. I was on that. I had my own podcast for a while. That ended, and then this began, and so without that, there would be no this, and without that, there would be no, without Barry, there'd be no this. So again, thank you, Barry, for helping me out, getting me started in making content for the internet, because I wouldn't be doing it otherwise. Speaking of someone that's been helping me for years, Tony in Indio, a good friend of mine from way back, about as far back as me and Jamelyn go, almost 20 years. I'm gonna date myself here. I've known him, again, since school. and really cool guy, always very supportive, leaves comments, sent me stuff, and it shares my shit all over the place. And then his friend Orlando actually made some of the music for the channel for a while. I've been using some different music recently. That might change, but we'll see what happens here in the future. Also, speaking of music, Antipolished, who did the theme for the show last year, I might be bringing that back. It kind of depends on what people like. But yeah, Antipolished, who Trevor Patterson, another guy I've known for a million fucking years, and it's his band. And he was kind enough to let me use their song Antipolished for the theme of the show, and I fucking love that song, so it's fucking awesome to use that as well. And then now we kind of go into the more modern times here. A guy that I met more fairly recently in the past couple years is John Wild. Was a guy I started out, I was just watching his videos. I was a fan of his work. And became a friend of mine, and now I'm in contact with him on a regular basis. He sends me stuff. I send him stuff. He's a great guy. I love his work. He needs to make more fucking videos. Anyway, John Wild, you need to do that. And I mean, he could do like a whole, you know, documentary series on the Mego Type 2 fat body. That would be awesome and hilarious. But anyway, thank you, John. And speaking of John Wild, there's always Count Stankus, who runs the Underworld Collectors page. Also has a gigantic YouTube channel. Big toy star on the internet is Count Stankus. And looked to little old me, left a comment, and then we became friends. I'm in contact with him on a fairly regular basis as well. And we do have some plans for the future to do some more stuff, so that's kind of cool. Look for me on his YouTube channel, and perhaps even vice versa. That's Count Stankus. Thank you, buddy. And the Underworld Collectors, of course, is the Facebook page, the group, in which him, me, Raz, all kinds of people are there. Just go to Facebook, search Underworld Collectors, and you can join the group, and you could come and talk to me and talk to all those people, and we can talk toys and collecting and share pictures of stuff we found and so on and so forth. But props to those guys. And then, you know, here we go. And of course, I would be remiss to forget my lovely wife, Erin, who's downstairs right now and can probably hear me say this. But hey, thank you. Thank you, babe, for always supporting the channel. And even though, you know, she's not into this stuff, she's not a weird sociopath toy collector like we are, but has always been supportive of the channel, watches the videos politely, and and supports me, which is the most important thing. So thank you. And then finally, last but not least, I want to thank everybody that subscribed, likes, comments, does all that good stuff, all the engagement shit that most YouTubers are begging you to do most of the time, including yours truly. I'm not above begging for that sort of engagement, and I'll do it on a regular basis because that engagement is what helps the channel grow. What gets it in front of more eyeballs. It's the leaving comments is going to lead to getting the video put in recommended on other videos that you've liked and commented on, and kind of spreads the video around and gets it in front of as many people as possible, which is kind of the point, because I know that my content might be a little niche, and so when it is, I gotta get it in front of as many people as possible to make sure I am getting those people that will like it. And so if you do know somebody that might like my channel, that might be into what we do here, share it with them, show them, leave a comment, let me know, please do, because that's what's gonna help me grow the channel, get bigger. I'll keep making more videos all the time. It's gonna keep me motivated, and thank you so much for doing that for me. I can't, from the bottom of my heart, thank you. All right, so now we're done sucking each other off. It's time for, we're gonna get down to business. This is the channel update. This isn't just me saying thank you to everybody. It's October. This is the first weekend of October, and this is gonna start another month, another October month of Halloween special videos, just like I did last year. Gonna do some more this year. There'll be fun skits, some bullshit, and cool horror figures all month long. So look forward to that. And at the end of the episode, stick around. There is a review. I'm reviewing some Universal Monsters bendies, not the same ones that I reviewed last year. Some brand new ones that I just picked up. And I thought, let's just kick it off with some bendies, just like we did last year. And into the future here. Before I let you go and check out the video, I want to put it in your hands down in the comments below. Let me know what you think about the channel. Let me know what you'd like to see in the future. Let me know what you'd like to see more of, what you'd like to see less of. If you have any ideas for things that I can bring to the table, things that I can do, things that you saw before in an old episode and you might want brought back, anything. It doesn't matter, even if it's not possible. I'll let you know. I read all the comments. I don't get that many of them to begin with, but I do. I read all the comments, so trust me, your comment doesn't go unread. So let me know down there what you think, and I will read it, and I will respond in some form or fashion. And you can also check out me on the check out the Dan Classic Show Facebook page. I update it every week when the new video comes out, and if you send me a message on there, I can respond to you there, and you can leave comments on the shares there if you want to, and I'll see them and I'll respond. Also, you can look up Dan Classic Show on Instagram. I hate using Instagram; it's a big pain in the ass. I have over almost 1,400 Instagram followers. It's such a joke. But the Instagram, I do a lot of the photo dumps, like all of the pictures I take that you see on the videos. I put a lot of them on Instagram. So if you want more of that, go to Instagram and you can check those out. I'm not gonna spam it. I'm not gonna put like 100 posts out in a day. So I'm not gonna like kill your feed with pictures of toys and stuff. So if I do, it's gonna be maybe 3 a day tops, if that. Most of the time, it's gonna be one in a day. Sometimes it's one in a week, because Instagram's a pain in the butt and I don't like using it. But I do know that it's important and that people do like it. So I participate and I put those pictures up there. And to be honest, the pictures do look cool. So go check them out, and you can follow me there too, and I'll also let you know when the new videos come out there, and so there you go. But don't forget, subscribe so that you don't miss a thing. So before any further ado, before any further screwing around, let's get down to the Halloween special for this year. It starts all starts this week, first week of October, with the Universal Monsters Bendy figures by Noble Toys. So it's Noble Toys Bendy Figs Universal Monsters Frankenstein. We're going to take a look at the Frankenstein box real quick here before we open him up, because I do like the very simple art on the box, sort of reminiscent of the Power Rangers box art. I like it. I think it's very cool, kind of simple, gets the job done. It's the Universal sort of, that's their branding. Looks very good. I like it. Very cool. Very cool box setup. We have a lot of words on this box, and we're going to take a look at some of them. Toylectable trademark figure with display stand. So Noble Toys has invented the Toylectable. Figurine Toylectable avec support. Oh, it's in French. And then in Spanish, in smaller, and then in German, in even smaller. So just going into smaller languages. It's all says the same shit. Universal Monsters, Bendy Thinks Frankenstein. We got a nice, very nice picture of Frankenstein monster on the back here, and the Collect 'Em All, Frankenstein, Bride of Frankenstein, Dracula, and the Creature from the Black Lagoon. I have yet to find these two. Only got Frankenstein and the Bride of Frankenstein. So we'll be just be taking a look at those today. I do plan on grabbing those two because, you know me, big Bendy fan. And I do think these are pretty neat. Or at least I do right now. So wait until I open it up. Maybe I'll change my mind. But until then, for right now, I do want the rest of them. One thing I am noticing, though, right off the bat, in the cross cell here, or the collect them all, if you will, we have Frankenstein in full color. We got a blue coat, we got sort of a brownish gray pants, blue shoes, green skin, right? Green skin here. As we turn the figure around, we have a black and white sort of presentation of Frankenstein, or at least very muted colors. The blues and greens really aren't coming through, more just a shades of gray on this. Maybe it was a decision they made. Obviously on the back is what they call a 3D sculpt. It's a fucking illustration of what the figure might look like. It's not an actual picture of the figure. So there you go. But that's the Frankenstein box. And here we have the Bride of Frankenstein. And you can tell right off the bat, these are a step above normal Bendy figures. They do come with a stand, and the sculpt on these are very, very nice. Nice looking paint jobs. We do have some packaging issues we might run into here, but it says all the same shit on the front and the back of the box. All the legal mumbo jumbo that you would expect. And of course, we have an illustration of the Bride of Frankenstein. She appears in the same colors either fucking way. But you can tell right away just by looking at this, we've got some very nice detail on the arms. I really do hope, I hope that these actually fucking bend and hold a pose. If they do, these are going to be some great goddamn bendies. But I can't wait anymore. Let's open these goddamn things up and see what they look like on the inside of the box. Alright, so right off the bat, I'm opening up the Bride here, and I'm seeing we have these ties, twist ties, and the little zip tie things that are shot through around the ankles. She ain't going fucking no place. But then we got plastic around the hands for some fucking... So much extra garbage goes into these things. So much waste. I really do. When it comes down to it, I really, really hate waste. I would prefer everything just comes in a reusable box that I can slide the figure back into when I'm done with it or whatever. If you want to call it a collectible, oh, I'm sorry, toilectable. If you want to call it that, great. I'm more power to you. But at the end of the day, we really need to think about how much waste we're putting into these things and how much garbage is the end result of opening up these packages. Because not only do you have the cardboard, the back there, the bubble goes on the front of the cardboard, this bubble, the inside bubble, then every little piece of plastic and bit and bob and tape and bullshit that goes into these things, that's just superfluous and is going to get thrown away. If you do open these things up, it's just going to get thrown away. And if you keep it in the box, it's going to look shitty because you can see the thing around the figure's neck. Anyway, just make the goddamn package right the first time. Obviously, they've sculpted this so the head of the fucking Bride of Frankenstein can fit. So why not just make it so the figure fits in there without having to put a bunch of extra horse shit on there? Okay, so we've got them both opened up, and here we have Frankenstein and the Bride of Frankenstein. Let's take a look at Frankenstein first here. Slide her over here and see, we have the black and white version. As I'm looking at it a little bit closer, it looks like the colors are there. They're just a bit muted. They're not, maybe they went in a different direction. They wanted to give it a more black and white look. And
as I'm handling the fucking figure, the tape that was around the hands has left adhesive on it, so he's got sticky goo on his fucking hands. All right, the stand is very nice. Has nice big pegs, two pegs for the two holes that go in the feet, and it holds the figure to stand up pretty well. Although this figure stands up pretty well by itself, the bendiness. This is the real test of a fucking bendy figure. Is that if you want to make a bendy fig or a bendy figure, as it should be, you know, it needs to fucking bend. That's the real problem here, is that this figure, because you could wash off the goo off the hands. The trash, it gets thrown away, and every fucking toy comes with a bunch of trash. There's not much that can be done about that. But at the end of the day, a fucking bendy figure, the most important thing about a bendy figure is that it bends and flexes and poses. And really, I'm getting stress lines on this thing as I'm trying to fucking bend it. You bend it and it doesn't really hold a pose. The arms are slightly more bendy, and you can kind of get the straight out sort of Frankenstein. It's more of a lackadaisical, like, I'm exhausted. Like sort of the arms straight out that you want from Frankenstein. The paint job's very good. The sculpt's very good. It's nice looking. It's kind of okay. But yeah, really, it's a bendy figure. And you know what? I wanna pay a little bit more. I can go out and get the neck of Frankenstein, which is looks like a goddamn masterpiece. And you know what? You really can't pose that without breaking it. But at the same time, you know what? If you just want a figure just to stand there, I mean, this ain't it. Like, $15? Come the fuck on, dude. All it's gonna do is stand there at attention, basically. It has a nice little stand. If you're into the Universal Monsters, I guess this is fine or whatever. He stands on the stand very nicely. He's not gonna go anywhere because he has a bendy, and he doesn't bend. Because look, he pops up every single time. So really, yeah, that's Frankenstein. Out of here, motherfucker. Now, let's take a look at the Bride of Frankenstein. We have a very interesting sculpt. The face is fucking awesome. The paint job's cool. She's got a fabric sort of gown on over her mummy body. A lady mummy, if you will. So they didn't even just, they didn't sort of mix and match on the bodies here. They gave her the actual body. Her posability, as far as her hands are concerned, are a little bit better. The shoulder, it's slightly better than our Frankenstein figure. She's not as stiff. is slightly more poseable. Still has the sticky shit on her hands and stuff. It's getting on her nice little gown, which I guess is fine if it looks a little shitty after a while, because it's, you know, it's supposed to. It's not supposed to be just bright white, right? And yeah. Oh, I guess you can remove it. Is there snaps or Velcro? There's Velcro on the back here, as if you wanted to take this off of her for some reason. The head sculpt, very cool. This is a very nice looking figure. I like this figure. Do I like this figure enough to pay $15 for it? I don't know. All right, so at the end of the day, the Universal Monsters Bride of Frankenstein and Frankenstein by Noble Toys Bendy Figs. Are these worth it? Are these worth $14.99 plus tax at retail or shipping, depending on how you fucking acquire these damn things? Are they really worth the better part of, $15 to $20? In my opinion, no. No, they are not. They're almost there. They're almost there. The presentation's very nice. The sculpt is very nice. The paint job's very nice. The packaging looked very, very nice. These stands are really cool. They're sturdy. They're solid. They hold the figure up. They do exactly what they're supposed to do. But at the end of the day, these things are called bendy figs, and they don't fucking bend. That's the problem with these things. They barely fucking bend. You can get a little bit more out of the Bride of Frankenstein, but you're not exactly going to get Spider-Man poses out of her, and it's a bendy fig. You're supposed to be able to get Spider-Man poses out of bendy figures. If it means that you got to make, that you got to stylize, you got to change up, you got to do something to the body to make it work for you, then fucking do it. Because at the end of the day, these are supposed to be bendy figures. These are supposed to be more than collectibles. They're toylectibles. We're supposed to be able to play with these things. That means they should be able to bend, pose, and hold a fucking pose. That's the measure of a bendy. And these things just don't measure up.